Swansea. What a shot! What a goal!
Lee Trundle's days as Swansea City's star striker may be in the past, but he's still scoring plenty of goals.
Come on.
Now the Swans club ambassador, Trundle, who turned 40 in October, has spent this season playing for Llanelli in Division 2 of the Welsh League, and it has been quite a year.
You waving?
Just about got to grips
with
waves. She does eye it, but...
Swans TV spent a match day with Lee as Llanelli looked to seal promotion.
So, Lee, big game tonight. West End v Llanelli.
Yeah, well, they haven't been doing too well at the moment. I think the last game we played them as well, we beat them 8-0, it was up at Llanelli, so... And I think they got beat again 8-0 on Saturday away to Porth. So they've been leaking a few goals, but you know, let's hope that I haven't put a dampener on it now and we get a 0-0 draw.
Yeah, because you're due a goal, aren't you? You didn't score the other
Yeah, we went up to Pontypridd and we drew 3-3. Yeah, I never scored in that game, first league game that I haven't scored in this year as well. So, you know, when it comes to the next game now, I'm wanting to put that right because I did want to go through the full season scoring in every single game, but you know, obviously that's not going to happen, but you know, I can still get my goal tally up.
What's your record now? Some people might have lost count, but
yeah, I'm on 41 in 22 games.
Pleased with that?
Yeah, please. People go on about the level or standard and stuff, but you know, I think whatever standard you play at, you've still got to score goals, you've still got to get the chances or create the chances yourself. So, you know, I'm playing in a league where, you know, I'm 40 now. You've still got, you know, young, fit lads who you're playing against. So, you know, to score that many goals in that many games, it's still pleasing for me.
When was the last time you got this sort of tally in the season?
Well, probably would have been, like, just before I signed for Wrexham. We had a team in Liverpool we were called a Quiet Man from one of our local pubs.
Right.
I scored 87 goals in 19 games.
Yes. Oh dear.
You know, we had a really good team.
Yeah.
And you know, we shouldn't have been in that league anyway. So
87 in 19, not a bad return.
Yeah. Yeah. No, I don't think I'll do that again.
What about after that? When you obviously started at Wrexham, and then everybody knows you came to the Swans.
Yeah. Do you know even?
What was your best? Can you remember?
I don't know whether my best for Swans was around. Was it 25, like that, or around that?
You got level. 20 every year, didn't you?
I got over 20 every year, which something, when I first come, that's something that I wanted to aim for because, you know, the last one person to score over 20 was Bob Latchford. So for me, being an Everton fan coming up and him being the last player to do it, I was pleased to do it every single season, except me one when I come on loan, and I only started two games So, but everyone when I was, you know, when the manager liked me, I got over 20 goals.
And then, after obviously, you didn't end up staying. You carried on.
Yeah, I went to Neath.
Was that follow? Was it?
Yeah, that was straight after.
Straight after that, I was trying to...
Straight after. Yeah, because people were surprised. I'd just come from the Championship and went to Neath. And, you know, a big part of that was I wanted to stay in Swansea as well. It got me to stay here where I wanted to be. Don't get me wrong, they offered me a good contract as well and a longer one that I got offered that off league clubs. And I think because I'd went to Bristol for money and, you know, I missed being away from Swansea, I missed being in the city. And when the time come again, you know, I was at the end of my career and I thought I'd rather be happy in my life than go somewhere for a year and just take whatever. So that was my decision. That's why I went to Neath, but it was a great bunch of lads and where I met our manager who's with us now, Andy Hill. You know, he was my strike partner at Neath, so you know, it was good times with a good bunch of lads there.
And that was a few years ago now, but you're still here, age 40, going strong.
Yeah. If I'm honest, Gaz, I don't wanna leave Swansea. You know, I think similar to the way Kurt's been at the club, you know, he's played a massive part in what our football club is, and you know, I'd like to think I've played a part in where it is myself, and it's just something that I want to be a part of. You know, I know obviously the playing days are over for Swansea, but to still represent them out and about in the city and going to schools and still seeing the kids and still playing football in the city, although I'm not playing for for Swansea. You know, I'll still have nearly every Swansea fan asking me questions about how I'm getting on and I'm doing well, and it's nice because most of these fans now, since I've been here, it's like that they've grown to be your friends because you see them day in, day out.
And going back to the football, fitness-wise, you're in great nick, aren't you, it looks like?
Yeah, but if I'm honest, guys, I probably train and look after myself better than I did when I was a pro, which is stupid. My missus, she's into all her healthy stuff, like her gluten-free, she's dairy-free, you know, she's a real good cook, so she cooks everything fresh, so it's like I've got my own in-house chef who looks after all
nutritionist
me.
Yeah, she is.
So, you know, a big part of it is the way she cooks for me, where when you're living on your own and you're in pack homes every single, twice a day, every day.
Maybe occasionally on Wine Street.
Yeah, that's it. I've probably done it the wrong way round. You know, I've stopped being a professional and go out more and look after myself better.
It's obvious you still love the game.
Yeah, well, for me, that's where I feel the happiest, you know, out on a football pitch, and I don't think you can't get a feeling like it. And it's like whether, you know, if you're scoring in front of 20,000 at the Liberty, or if I'm scoring here tonight inside, you still get that same feeling.
Yeah, it's just as good.
Yeah, it is. You might not get the noise where, you know, the fans go up, but, you know, the feeling of scoring a goal. I'm one of these where even if I'm training or I'm playing with the kids in the soccer schools and I score, I'll still celebrate. It's just, you know, football is about scoring goals, and I think it's for me, it's a very special thing, and I'll always keep trying to play as long as I can.
Do you think you could still be playing at a higher level than you are?
I think I could play in the league, definitely, yeah.
In the Football League?
Yeah, I think I could.
Even now?
Yeah, I think I could play League 2, definitely. Even League 1 if I was managed properly. I think the thing for me would, and I think it's the same for any person who's around 40, is your recovery and how you recover after games or after training. I think if I had to go in and at a League 2 club and train every single day like them lads, come match day, I wouldn't be at my best. I'd be probably, you know, I'd be stiff. I'd might have picked up a little couple of injuries, but you know, if I was looked after, I believe ability wise, and I could still play. But you know, it's for me now with my job at Swansea and playing for Llanelli, it's perfect for me.
Nearly at the ground, nearly at West End. Got to get you, stop chatting to me and get your mind on the game, Trans, haven't you?
Yeah, I think, you know, I'm one of these where I'd always still have a laugh and mess about in the changing room before games. It's just as soon as I'm about to go out onto the pitch, you know, that's when I start focusing in, and I try to just keep it as like relaxed as I can, and then, you know, when I get out there, then do the business, hopefully.
And if you're a bookie, what price would you give on a Lee Trundle goal any time tonight in the 90 minutes?
I don't want to jinx myself, but I reckon that you'd be giving your money away if you were the bookie saying that.
Difficult week for you boys, well for us. Keyword is discipline, wasn't it? In all aspects. You know, discipline in your state of mind and discipline in your shape. Same old there, boys. Don't get involved. Like Dickie said, we don't want him to shoot on any. Right? We want him to win every tackle, every second ball, every header, but you do it in the right way, right? Exactly on the same level, boys, and your quality will come through, obviously, right? Right? Come on.
Thank you.
the verdict?
Yeah, scrappy game, but you know, at this stage of the season, to come away from home and win 3-0, you know, it's a good result at the end.
Yeah, you had to battle, didn't you?
Yeah, well, you know, when you come into these, when they're struggling at the bottom, it's always going to be a battle. And, you know, the pitch looked all right from the side, but once you're on it, it's very bobbly. So, you know, we'll take the win.
You got your goal?
Yeah, I was happy to end my 90-minute goal drought, so nice to get one back.
And you said to me earlier that a goal at this level feels as good as one at the Liberty. And you stand by that?
Yeah, listen, a goal's a goal. As I said, it's not the same roar off the jacks behind you. You know, I miss that. I miss hearing that roar, but it's still nice to go home at the end of the game when you've scored a goal. Yeah, I think we're almost there for promotion, but when you've had a season like this, you know, you want to finish it off in style.